this is my 20 gallon in the office. This tank's gone through several iterations. Originally, it was some gravel down at the bottom and a big pile of stones, and two epic fails with Hillstream loaches. And then I thought, well, okay, I put the last two Hillstream loach survivors in my 75 gallon out in the garage, whether or not they're still alive. I think one of them came out and died. God, I hate losing fish. And then I put Mickey Mouse platies in here. And I thought, well, I'm going to get some. Oh, and I also put some bronze corys in here. I think there's four or five. I don't remember. They're from a spawn from a year ago, October. So they're a little over a year old now. And they're doing right. And then I put, I thought, you know, I'm going to put green jade shrimp in here after I put the Mickey Mouse platies in here. And I'm not sure if the Mickey Mouse platies kind of helped cull the population. But I got a second batch of Blue Dream shrimp. I'm sorry, I said Blue Dream shrimp. They should be Green Jade shrimp. So I got a second batch of Green Jade shrimp. Same vendor in Texas, guy named Tommy. And if I remember, I'll put the link down below again. I like dealing with him. One of the first vendors on eBay that I recall that sent me a message that said, your product is on the way. I like that. I do that all the time now. But anyway, they seem to be doing kind of well. He did send me a message that said, there's a lot of variation in the coloring, and I'm seeing that. And I don't know what I'm going to do about it just yet. I think maybe I've got to look. The light's not really good in this tank. There's a lot of cover. I've got this... it's called Rickia Water Spangles, and it's making a really dense cover on the top of the tank. And I just dropped in a handful of black alder cone stems, or actually they're the stalks that hold the little cones to the stems. A little horticulture there for you. But you can see, I hope, without all that glare, these are the green jades just sort of milling around. There's a bunch of them. I don't see any really tiny ones yet. I'm betting there's some, though. And then I dropped in a bunch of dried Dracaena leaves. I think it's Dracaena marginata, houseplant. They drop. I pick them up. I drop them in the tank. There's a snail on that leaf. And there's another snail against the wall over here. I had a really bad bladder snail infestation. I got rid of most of them. There's another one right there. Get my finger in there, right there. Dropping zucchini in. And you know, a lot of people will drop it in on a fork so it sinks. I just dropped it and let it float. It's easier to get. And then I fish them out, go to the sink and rinse them off and just send them down the drain. They're starting to make a little comeback, so I will hand pick the ones I can get to, and I'll drop some zucchini in and pick out the rest. They move really quick that way. But this tank from about here this way is just gravel. And from here this way, it's, I think it was just pool sand and then a little bit of gravel on top. I wanted something to plant these plants into. And I stuck some jungle valves in here. One of them came all the way over here. Bigger, there we go. Came all the way from back here to here. I don't remember planting this one. And then I planted a bunch of crips through here, and they're all doing really well. That just produces more food source for the shrimp. I got all the fish out here. Last time I did a partial water change on this tank, I collected all the Mickey Mouse platies, and there were some really tiny ones, and I am amazed that I got them all. So the only fish in here right now are the bronze corys, and I don't know if I'll put some other... I might put, I've got some glow light tetras. I might put them in here. There should be a piece. Yeah, there is a piece of a Java fern back under here. And then there's also hornwort. But a place for, if I put the glow light tetras in here, maybe they could spawn over this, drop their eggs in amongst these crypts into the gravel substrate that's in this pot. Java fern's finally starting to grow. I've not had much luck with that yet, but it's finally starting to take off. I think fertilizing regularly helps. And then I've got a, looks like, I think that's a type of bulbitis on the log here, on this piece of spiderwood. And then there's also Windelove Java fern. And then there's another piece of, you know, whatever the species Java fern is, and a piece of Anubias on that other piece of spiderwood. There are a lot of pieces here floating around. But that's all cool. So anyway, I know I started talking about putting the leaves in there, the Dracaena leaves. Make sure they're dry. I just, you know, they fall off. They're pretty dry. I just leave them sitting around for another week or so. Things dry out really quick here in the desert. And then I put them, I grab these in a handful, and I set the piece of spider wood on top of them, and it kept most of them down. A couple floated up. There's one floating here. And they eventually all sink, and the shrimp start feeding on those. I was just watching a father fish short about all the different kinds of leaves, and that's what kind of gave me the idea. I also use banana leaves, dried banana leaves, dried bird of paradise leaves. Make sure they're really well dried, you know, and chop them up into smaller pieces. Banana and bird of paradise, you can kind of rip into long strips, and you can boil them. I don't bother. I just put them in the tank. They eventually sink. You can pin them down with something. That works. I've got a bunch of leaves out here in the garden right next to me. And I'll grab handfuls of those and just rinse the dust off them and use those. That's from this brachychiton tree up there. And that works really well. Occasionally I will drop some of the algae wafers in here that I get. And the quarries, the little bronze quarries, like this as well. So they'll come and school around it or whatever they do. They come and feast on it. And then the shrimp like that too. It's a good source of food. Adds a little bit of extra stuff. Mostly this tank just sort of is self-reliant. But it's good to throw something in once in a while. And once in a while I will throw in some frozen bloodworms because the quarries like those. And catfish love their worms. And whatever's left, the shrimp will pick up. And I've seen shrimp just grab a piece of bloodworm and take off with it. And occasionally I'll drop some dry food in here too. Not often. Yeah, you know, I don't want to foul the water. And there was a lot of mulm and stuff floating around when I did that water change and took out all the little Mickey Mouse platies. So I've got a hang on back filter sitting on it right now. And I'll get that out of here now because it's pretty much done. I've got a small sponge filter in there. And that seems to be enough to keep this tank running well. So anyway, just more about it. Anyway, just my two cents on this tank. Kind of an update on the green jade shrimp tank. And I got to clear off all this Rickia water spangle. I guess I should just grab a few handfuls and toss it. I ain't doing that, but I guess that's what I should do. And I tried selling it on eBay. Nobody seems to be very interested. Maybe I'll put it up again. Maybe some will go. But anyway, fighting a nasty cold too. This is just no fun. That's kind of where we are right now on this tank, this 20 gallon in my office. And it's doing really well. I get a little algae from the light because I leave the blind open on this side. So this end of the tank gets more algae. I wipe down, you can see that green powder algae across on the other glass. So I wipe down the two long sides and the other end and just leave that one green. And that's food source for the shrimp anyway, and probably those damn snails too. But regardless, it's what it is, huh? So like I always say, I really appreciate y'all. If I've earned it from you, I hope if you haven't already, you'll subscribe to the channel and at least give a like. That helps. And we will catch you all on whatever it is. Thanks for looking.